The Meg Whitman for Governor campaign is running a lot of TV ads attacking Jerry Brown's four decades in politics.
Yeah, the ads make a lot of allegations, but do the facts back them up?
ABC 7 political reporter Mark Matthews, I say because I'm closer to him, joins us for the fact check.
Well, you know, the ad is getting a lot of airplay, but it's not getting very high marks for accuracy.
The Jerry Brown story.
Meg Whitman's ad revolves around Jerry Brown's four decades in politics.
In the 60s, Brown enters politics and later serves two terms as governor. His big spending turns a surplus into a billion-dollar deficit.
Fact check? That's misleading. As we pointed out in an earlier fact check, Brown wasn't a big spender. California's deficit resulted from a deep national recession and Prop 13, which Brown opposed.
Brown appoints liberal judges who fight the death penalty, supports billions in new taxes, and leaves the state with record unemployment of 11%. Failure.
Fact check, it's accurate to say that he appointed a liberal judge. Rose Byrd did oppose the death penalty. But the $7 billion in new taxes is not accurate. $2 billion came from an increase in the gas tax, which was supported by nearly half the Republicans in the legislature. The rest of Whitman's claim comes from a quarter-cent hike in sales tax, which Brown proposed, but which was not enacted.
In the 80s, he runs for Senate, but Californians say no. He lobbies for a corporate polluter and works to send California jobs to China.
Fact check? Again, misleading. Brown was never a paid lobbyist for the biomedical firm that put him on the board. The ad rests on a single phone call that Brown made to Congressman Henry Waxman, who later complained that Brown had lobbied him on behalf of the medical firm's founder. But the call had nothing to do with pollution, and as for working to send jobs to China, Brown did go to China in the late 80s, but he denied a San Francisco Examiner report that said he was there scouting for a factory for the biomedical firm, and there has been no hard evidence to prove it.
The 90s saw Jerry run as a presidential candidate against Bill Clinton.
You know, he reinvents himself every year or two.
Failure.
Fact check. This part of the ad is accurate. After that bruising presidential primary, Clinton and Brown have yet to reconcile.
And in the 2000s, Jerry was mayor of Oakland, where he taxed everything from garbage to cable TV. Crime soared, and he damaged the school system so badly, the state had to take it over. Another failure.
Fact check? The ad falsely claims that crime soared in Oakland. The number of crimes actually went down by more than 13%. It's also false that Brown damaged the school system. As mayor, he had almost no control over the school district budget problems that preceded his term as mayor and that led to the state takeover.
Now, our partners at factcheck.org have a lot more detail on this fact check. And since we don't have time to tell you all about that now, we're going to tell you to go to our website at abc7news.com. If you click on this story, we will link you to that factcheck.org article. It's several pages long, a lot of detail on this particular ad, and we will be fact-checking Jerry Brown's ads as soon as they start.
She's got a lot of money. She's buying lots of ads.
Yeah. Mark, thanks very much. All right.